just get the elephant out of the room. How's Nolan?
There's an elephant?
Yeah, apparently. How's Nolan? It's rumored that he was seen with a sling over his left shoulder. What's his overall status as of right now, and could he miss any time?
Yeah, we'll find that out as we go. I'm not sure what kind of time he'll miss or won't miss. I honestly don't know that. They're going to have to run more tests on him. Obviously, it's unfortunate the situation we were in with a late hit on top of him. I didn't watch it. I was watching something else. I was watching the blocking scheme, and I didn't see the late hit. So I wouldn't even be able to tell you what it looked like and how it happened.
Hey, Ryan, with the way you guys started the game, really kind of moving down the field quickly the first couple of times, would you have liked to have seen a little bit more off?
You're smirking. I'd like to do that every drive.
A little bit more offensive consistency after that.
Yeah, I would. Again, there are some circumstantial things that happened there. I do think there was a pass interference that was missed on the interception. And I think we ran out of time, obviously. We had first and one from the one, and we had one chance at it, and we would have scored there, obviously, on four downs. And we missed a field goal. So I think, there were points that we obviously needed. I guess this game we didn't necessarily need them, but we will need them. We need to continue to work on being a little bit more consistent. I think that's a good word. I was happy we started fast this week, got that out of the way. We still haven't played a four-quarter game as a team yet, I think that's okay. We have to continue to get better. I thought we had our best week of practice this week. I was hoping that translated into a four-quarter game, but hopefully, working in a new set of offensive linemen there, a new, group per se, hopefully that, that 1 week of reps and film and getting coached up by Coach Rogers will get us a little bit more consistent as we go next week.
Were you concerned at all just the momentum swing at halftime? Not that you weren't still in good shape, but they were pretty excited about the stop, and you guys were disappointed?
No, yeah. I was not. I thought we had a situation where, they stopped us on one play, and it's unfortunate, and it shouldn't happen. We should have been able to score there for 1 yard, we didn't, but that's not going to deter us. We're not going to be – one play is not going to dictate much for us. The analytics people would say momentum doesn't exist. So.
Artis, you looked like you had a few words to say to your fellow defenders after they scored that touchdown. Tell us about what you had to say.
Reminder, there's no bleep button here.
Summarize.
Yeah, just a little short little thing. But I was just basically just I know our potential on defense, and obviously on that drive, we weren't playing to our full potential. We already set the bar from game one, And with those types of drives, that's not acceptable because that's not who we are. And we can play so much higher than that, So I just wanted to uplift my teammates and let them know, we got each other's back. We're going to be fine, Everybody just got to do their job, and we're going to be fine.
Artis, the rest of the game, did you feel like you guys as a defense did a pretty good job? You limited them to 158 yards or something like that, leading rusher, and the MEAC didn't really, hurt you. Again, except for that, that one drive a little bit. But did you feel like the rest of the game that you guys did kind of what you wanted to do?
Oh, 100%, 100%. I just felt like when we went into halftime, we went in there calm. We already knew, it's okay. We're gonna come back out here and do what we need to do, And I wasn't worried at all. I knew he was going to do that. And I just played Delaware defense. And so, yeah.
Hey, Marcus, what happened on that touchdown? Was that a design play or was it a broken play? You were just giving him some place to go with the ball?
It was a design play, but the scramble drill, we work on that constantly in practice. So when he rolled out, I just put the jets on. And it worked out.
Knew he had you there?
Yeah.
And this isn't the first time that you've had a big play touchdown of over 70 yards. Just how does it feel to just be a big playmaker for this offense overall?
I just feel confident when I'm on the field, with coaching and the players, they believing in me. So I feel as though it's easy to make a big play when it's open and everyone is doing their job. So I wouldn't put that on me. I say the team does that.
Ryan, what is it about Nolan that makes him so effective at scrambling? you know, just the fact that he's kind of out in the open and can, you know, is so athletic out there and tough to catch. And
he's very good at it, and I don't want to take away from him being good at it. But, you know, we have a saying around here that the ball finds energy, mm-hmm. and that energy is a talent. And we have guys going, and we work scrambles a lot, you know, and it's something that we really believe in. And these guys do a great job at getting open at that point. We have scramble rules. We have practice. We practice it all the time. We have, you know, drills about them. And they're confident in each other. Right. You know what I mean? They know that Nolan's going to be able to find him if he keeps his eyes up, and that Nolan knows that those guys are going to work for him. And so, you know, I think some people are a little better at it than others. You know, as far as the receivers and the tight ends and the running backs, they have a knack for it. But it's something you can work on.
Right. So even though, you know, a scramble can kind of be chaos, it's kind of organized chaos, basically.
100%.
Right, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Coach, I know it was the end of the game, but the team looked really, really happy for O'Connor and mm-hmm. Little Buckman.
Was that Buckman's first touchdown?
I don't know. That was
anybody know that? Somebody said that on the head.
I think it is.
We need Plaskin in here. Plaskin would know.
I was already down on the sideline. I know it's that.
Yeah, it was certainly OC's. But, yeah, I obviously, you know, that team loves each other, you know, and it's a tight group that works out there every day and gets after it with each other every day. So they're going to celebrate when, you know, when their boys make a play for the first time. And it was fun to see. It's fun to see that kind of energy. That's the kind of energy we bring to practice. That's the kind of energy we're going to bring on game day as well. And so, you know, that's a celebration out of love more than anything else.
Hey, you know, it's only one series, but I mean, like with yourself and Connor.
Absolutely. You know, and I told Zach after the first drive, I'm like, hey, you're going to get this drive, you know, after he went in, obviously, for Nolan. And I said, I want to get OC a drive this week because he hadn't had one, you know, and he practices his butt off. And, you know, those two guys split two reps in practice, and I wanted to see what he could do in a game, and he did a great job.
It was his first career.
It was Buck's first touchdown, too? That's awesome.
That's what's up.
Hey, Artis, obviously, you guys got some big games coming up. You know, this is where a Delaware football team wants to be. You know, you want to go into your last few games, you know, in a good position, a chance to make the postseason. You know, how do you guys feel about being in that position, and you know, what's going to be important for you as you head into this next game at Elon?
I feel like just being put in this position, it just forces us to step up and do even better than what we're doing. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And just with this being the next game is always going to be the biggest game. You know what I mean? We take it week by week. We're not looking at the team two games from now. It's always the next game up, and the A-line is the next game up. And I feel like we always push ourselves to be better than where we were last week. So I feel like we're going to do what we need to do and handle our business for us to be prepared for this upcoming week.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Mark, tonight you don't know what's going on yet with Nolan, but always tough to see a teammate get hurt like that and see him, you know, your starting quarterback there with his arm managed like that.
You know, injury is tough. I feel as though it's just a part of the game. Anyone can get hurt at any play, any point in the game. It's just tough, you know. I know Nolan gonna work to get back, and he gonna come back even stronger. So that's just a challenge that the next team gotta worry about.
Coach, it looked like they actually had a pretty good defensive backfield, and they were trying to cover the deep balls and take that away from you. But, you know, can you comment on that?
Yeah, they did a pretty good job. I mean, they're good. It's not a bad – it's not a terrible defense, you know. I mean, I know they've given up some points to a couple teams out there, some really good ones. But that's a good secondary. It's probably what their strength is. You know, I thought we missed a couple early, made a couple, obviously. And then, you know, once we settled down a little bit, I think we kind of – nickel and dimed them a little bit, but they're good. They had some talent out there.
Hey, Coach, what's the plan for overall with, like, the kicking unit? Because you keep on going back and forth between Bennion and McMullen, and Bennion missed that 28-yarder, and then I think it was a 39-yarder made by McMullen. Mm-hmm. What's your faith in that kicking team so far? And you also had a couple opportunities to kick some field goals in the first half, but you opted to go for it.
Mm-hmm.
Did that play into a factor, or is it just your aggressive mindset?
A little bit of both. You know, when I go for it, it's probably analytically the sound move, but those are based on, you know, the confidence in the kicker as well. And so, you know, I don't know what our plan is. Taking suggestions. What do you think our plan should be? Who do you like? Yeah, I thought so. All right. Right now, I mean, we were very excited to see McMillan hit that kick at the end there. I think that's something that he's got a lot of leg talent, but he's still young, you know, and I think he needed that for confidence boost. You know, I thought you see the next kickoff right after it popped off his leg too. You know, it'll be good for him to continue to get reps at it, because they've been working really hard and competing hard in practice, and getting better, all of them. And so, you know, we just got to get some consistency. Sometimes it's reps, right? I mean, you've seen, you know, freshman quarterbacks go out there and not do great early, right? And the more reps they get in games, they get better at it. And it's tough when field goals are tough, man, because you are the only person that they're looking at. And if you miss that one on your first one, it's tough on confidence, you know? And so it was great to see him bounce back from one of his misses and go hit one, because he's got the talent to do it. McMillan does.
Hey, Coach, you talked about one of the first things you said, you talked about the offensive line and the new. So is that
reimaging?
Is that just based on performance that you decided to make those changes?
Yeah, there were a couple things that involved in it, but you know, it's probably what we'll look like now.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
Thanks, you guys.
Thank you.
Thank you.